Stormy Daniels, the adult film star whose real name is Stephanie Clifford, will appear on 60 Minutes this Sunday, CBS announced. Daniels, through her attorney, alleges that she and Trump had an extramarital affair over 10 years ago. Earlier on Wednesday, the president also defended his congratulations to Putin on the Russian president's disputed re-election victory on Wednesday, saying he wants Putin's help in solving crises from North Korea to Syria and beyond. Trump drew fire from Republicans and Democrats alike for telling reporters on Tuesday that he had congratulated Putin on his re-election and that the two leaders had made tentative plans to meet in the not-too-distant future. The Washington Post reported that Trump, in his briefing papers to prepare for the phone call with Putin on Tuesday, was specifically warned to not congratulate the Russian president. White House officials did not dispute the report, but said whoever leaked it could be subject to dismissal. Despite the turmoil, Trump could savor the budget agreement, which he is expected to sign. U.S. congressional budget negotiators said Wednesday they had reached a deal on federal spending for the remainder of fiscal 2018, 2 days before a deadline to fund the government or risk a shutdown. The $1.3 trillion spending bill was hailed by House Speaker Paul Ryan, Congress's top Republican, as marking the beginning of a new era for the United States military, while Senate Minority Leader Chuck Schumer said it would fulfill Democratic priorities. It was introduced with precious little time to act. Government funding expires at midnight Friday night, and the House of Representatives and Senate will need to scramble if both chambers are to pass the measure and get it signed by Trump by the deadline. The White House later said Trump supported the deal. It signals an end, or at least a pause, to the deeply partisan feuding over funding that has roiled Congress for months. Five times lawmakers have had to pass stopgap funding legislation to keep the government's lights on, and twice this year the government was allowed to slip into shutdown. A third lapse would be deeply embarrassing for a Republican-controlled Congress facing midterm elections in November. The bill sets defense spending levels, including a 2.4% raise for troops, at $700 billion for the year, an increase of $61 billion over the 2017 level. Trump and other Republicans have repeatedly raised the alarm about the country's military and how it has been severely depleted from budgetary constraints. Non-defense domestic spending will reach $591 billion, an increase of about 10%. 11th hour snags on multiple issues, including immigration enforcement, border security, infrastructure and healthcare payments, had bogged down the release of the monster measure. The bill includes nearly $1.6 billion for construction of almost 100 miles, 160 kilometers, of physical barriers and fencing along the U.S.-Mexico border. And while it does not include any provisions that defund so-called sanctuary cities, where authorities do not take action against undocumented immigrants who don't commit crimes, it fails to address protections for more than a million immigrants who arrived in the country illegally as children. Democrats can meanwhile claim increased domestic spending on issues like infrastructure, education, and battling the opioid crisis.